We're really excited to be able to tell our employees in the community in Granite City, Illinois, that we will be calling back 500 employees. This feels like the beginning of a renaissance for us. We're finally doing the right thing for American workers after decades of unfairly traded steel into the United States. So we're really happy and delighted to share with everybody that we're getting back on track after so many years.
Mr. Burritt, the Granite City facilities had been idled since December of 2015. What happened? What caused the idling?
Well, it's the unfair trade. You know, if you're not, if you don't have customers here to sell to and you can't make money, you have to shut them down. And we've seen our facilities go from 15 facilities here in the most recent years down to 7. Thing to remember here is that U.S. Steel was the original iconic corporation. Back in 1901, we actually had a value of $1 billion, a market capitalization of $1 billion. And in January of 2016, we were actually less than $1 billion. And here we are working hard every day, trying to get the things back on track. And we finally get some good news because we got some courageous leadership in the administration. And big, big thanks to Commerce Secretary Ross and certainly President Trump for taking the leadership and righting some wrongs. It's really important that we get this right, and finally it's happening.
One more very quick question. What we've heard in the pushback from people on the opposite side of this issue this week has been that, look, the jobs aren't going to come back regardless, that so much has been automated in the steel industry and in the aluminum industry. What do you say to that argument?
Well, I think the jobs are coming back, and for every job that comes back, the statistics that we've seen is that for every job that comes back, you multiply it by about 7. So there will be jobs coming back. And, you know, you think about U.S. Steel, we're an integrated mill. So we have mine sites in Minnesota. We have we go to Appalachia for our coal. And so when we bring back jobs, it has impacts on our surrounding communities. But the more important issue here is you got to be able to make stuff in the United States. And if you take away our ability to make things, to manufacture things, you don't really have a society. You just think about the way the UK was. It used to have a big manufacturing base. It went away. And if you don't make stuff, you can't have a strong country. You can't protect yourselves, and you go by the way of Greece or maybe Puerto Rico. We have to be able to make things in the United States. It's really important that we do. That's the bigger issue. If you take away the steel industry, you're going to be held hostage to those outside this country, and you won't be able to take care of yourself. That's the real issue.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.